Hi, I'm Danny. Welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'll go over cooling fans and how they work. The information that I'm about to share with you should help you better understand the engine cooling system so you can diagnose your own vehicle if it's running hotter than normal or overheating. I'll start by going over a couple of things that you should check that'll cause your vehicle to run hot. Then I'll jump right into how the fans work. Let's get started. Coolant's a vital part of the cooling system, and having the correct amount of coolant in your system needs to be verified first. Never remove the radiator cap on a warm or hot engine. The coolant is under pressure and you will get burned. Always check the coolant level when the engine is cold. The coolant should be clean and at the proper level. If your coolant is low, you'll need to top it off before you go any further. If your coolant has oil in it or your oil has coolant in it, that's going to be an engine problem, and I'm not going to cover that in this video. You'll also want to check for trouble codes. If you find trouble codes, that's where you're going to start your diagnostic process. I recently picked up this 2023 Launch X431 Elite OBD2 bidirectional scan tool. This is designed for Honda and Acura vehicles only. I'll be using this today to help me in my diagnostic process. I also have a full video on the Launch X431. I'll link that in the description. Let me give you a quick overview of the fans and how they work on my 2009 Honda Civic. The fans are controlled by the computer. There's also sensors, fuses, relays, wires, and switches. But don't worry, I'll simplify the diagnostic process for you. The fans should come on whenever the ignition key is in the run position and the AC is turned on. The reason for this is the fans need to pull air across the radiator and condenser. This helps the AC blow cold when the car is not moving. When the air conditioner is not on, the fans will only come on if the temperature reaches around 212 degrees, and then it'll go off as soon as it reaches normal operating temperature. The computer is always trying to maintain operating temperature. This is set by the manufacturer for that vehicle. A quick way to test the fans is to turn on the ignition switch to the run position with the AC on. Both fans should come on. If they do, you just verified the fans, relay, switches, fuses, and wires are all working properly. If one or both fans don't come on, I have a video on my channel that'll address this issue. I'll leave a link in the description. If the fans are working properly with the AC on, but don't come on with the AC off, and the engine is above 212 degrees, you'll need to check the coolant temperature sensor for proper operation. Let me explain. If you made it this far in the video, take a minute and subscribe to my page. 95% of you who watch my videos don't subscribe. It really helps me out if you're a subscriber. That's what this channel is all about. It's helping each other out. Please take a minute and hit that subscribe button to help me out. Now, back to the video. There's two engine coolant temperature sensors, or ECT sensors. The computer monitors both these sensors to determine the engine's temperature. Sensor number one is here at the top of the engine. This helps control air-fuel ratio, timing, idle speed, and many other functions by sending feedback to the computer. There's also many codes associated with this sensor to help you diagnose it. That's why I said earlier, checking for diagnostic codes is where you want to start first. Coolant temperature sensor number two is located at the bottom of the radiator. This also sends feedback to the computer and is the sensor that allows the computer to turn on the fans once the conditions have been met. Like sensor number one, this has diagnostic trouble codes. Remember I said this vehicle has two engine coolant temperature sensors? Well, my scan tool needs to be able to read sensor one and sensor two individually.
So I'm gonna compare scanners. So this is a $30, $40 scanner, and I also have a $200 scanner, and then a $500 scanner. And we're gonna compare what data you get with each one that's gonna help you. So we're gonna go to all data. We're gonna say okay. And then we gotta look at the data that comes up. So on this one, we're looking for engine coolant. So there's engine coolant. It's at 143 degrees right now. I'm gonna press this for 2 seconds and it's gonna put it at the top. Now let's see if we can find any other engine coolant temperature sensors, because this doesn't say engine coolant temperature one or two. It just says engine coolant temperature. So far, nothing. There's a lot of information, but as far as my engine coolant temperature sensor, this little scan tool is useless. So let's go see our $200 scanner and see if that gives me engine coolant temperature sensor one and two, because this one is not helpful for me. This is the launch scanner that I was talking about earlier in the video. So on this one, if I come over here to read data stream, and then I'm gonna manually select, and then here's all the options here. And these are all in alphabetical order, and there's a lot more than what was in the other scanner. So you pay more and you're getting more, but let's see if there's engine coolant one and two, because the other one just had engine coolant temperature one. Looks like I passed it. Let's go to engine. Oh, there we go. So engine coolant temperature sensor one and sensor two. So let's select both of those and say okay. And there we go. It's telling us engine coolant temperature one is 138 degrees and engine coolant temperature two is 82 degrees. Already we got more information. So now we can see engine coolant temperature one and two. So let's go to the $500 scanner and see what kind of information that's gonna give us. All right, so here's the ANOVA SD S50. This is about a $500 scanner. So here's the data on this one. I'm going to push the custom button and then we're going to select the engine coolant sensor. And already I see engine coolant sensor one. That's the voltage. And engine coolant sensor one, that's the temperature. So I get voltage and temperature. On the other one, I got only temperature. So let's keep going and let's find engine coolant temperature sensor number two. I'm guessing it's in here, but I don't see it. Let's keep going. Oh, there it is. Engine coolant temperature sensor number two. There's the voltage. And there's that. So we're gonna say done. All right, so here I've got engine coolant sensor one. It's got 1.45 voltage. Engine coolant temperature sensor number one, 132 degrees. Engine coolant temperature sensor number two, 2.78 volts. And it's reading 80.60 degrees. So this one gives you the voltage and the temperature. That's what you get for $500. So I can measure the voltage on the sensor by using a voltmeter, and I'll show you how to do that.
All right, with the engine coolant temperature sensor number 2 disconnected, I need to front probe the connector because 5 volts should be coming to the connector, and on the other side will be ground. So I've got my meter all hooked up, and I'm just going to front probe right here. And then if I get my meter, I could show you. Right there, I have 5 volts. Now let me go to the ground side, and I should have near 0 volts here. And on that one, I've got 0.02 volts. So this shows I'm getting the 5 volt signal from the computer, and I'm getting a good ground. Now, what this does is it supplies 5 volts here, and then it goes through the sensor to the ground, and then whatever's left, the computer reads as voltage. So next, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna back probe that 5 volt reference wire. I'm gonna go ahead and plug this in. And now that 5 volt reference is going through that sensor, which is a thermal sensor. And then it's losing some of the 5 volts, and the computer's reading it. So let me show you the meter. So right now the meter is reading 3.19 volts. When that gets to about a half a volt or 0.6 volts, the fans will come on. All right, so let me show you how my meter's hooked up. So I've got the green in the comm and the red. That was the one that I was back probing with. There it is underneath the car. But the green wire comes right over here, right to a good battery ground. All right, so I've got the launch scanner all hooked up. It's at engine coolant temperature sensor 1 is at 159. Engine coolant temperature 2 is at 107 degrees right now, and both fans are off. If I come over to my meter, let's get some light on there. It's 1.94 with the meter here. So that's the voltage. So I'm measuring the voltage on that sensor number 2, 1.88 now. 8.7, it's dropping. When that hits about 0.5, 0.6, the fans should come on. And we'll just wait a little bit longer and see how that works. So the fans should be coming on pretty quickly here. I'm at 0.54 and 203 degrees on coolant temperature sensor 2. And 208 on coolant temperature sensor 1. It says fan high is off and fan low is off. I'm at 212 now, 0.5 on the meter. Oh, both fans just came on at 212 and 0.5. And they're still on. You can see they're on right here. Now they're off. So that's how the fans work. Now if I let it roll again, it'll just continue that little process. Let's go ahead and just let it roll again. Keep an eye on the fans and the temperature. So when the temperature hits 212, the fans will come on, and when it hits, I forget what it was hitting, but it was right around 0.5. So temperature is rising now. We have 204, 203, and 0.55, 0.54, 208. I think it happened when it was 212. And then watch your fans down here. Coolant temperature sensor 2's down here. Coolant sensor, there they are. They're both on, and we're at 0.5, 212, 204. Both fans are on still. Now they're off. So that's how the system works. So I'm going to show you this with the more expensive scan tool. So this one, engine coolant temperature sensor 2. You can see it's 0.5 volts and 212 degrees. So the fans should be coming on at any time now. Oh, there they are. They went on. So this one shows you voltage, temperature, voltage on sensor 1, and temperature. So this shows you the fans. This shows you pretty much everything you need to know on there. So the more you pay for a scanner, the more you get. You may not need your meter. So, but that's how fans work on the Civic. We'll go ahead and let that go one more time. Engine coolant sensor 1, 0.53, 203 degrees. Sensor 2, 0.55, 201 degrees. Let's just let it roll and let's see where it goes from here. Sensor 1 is 208. I believe it hits 212. They come on. They should come on any second now. There they are. They're on. There's the fan on. And when the fan goes off, it'll do its whole cycle again. Fans are off.
There's one more thing that I want to show you before I end this video. The launch scanner can actually turn on the fans. If you can command the fans on with the scanner, then you're verifying the computer is good, and it's most likely going to be a sensor that's causing your problem. I know this video has been longer than my normal videos, but I tried to cover every possible scenario on cooling fans. As far as scan tools, just get the one that you can afford. Any scan tool is better than nothing. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Consider subscribing. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.